Hey Kawan, welcome to EDC Ready. Today we are not doing a review of knife, but we are doing a review of knife scales. Now before I continue, I want to give a big shout out and big thank you to Hadif. Hadif works at Gear Evo. You can check out their link in the description down below. I don't know if they have a website, but I'll link you to their Shopee sales site where you can check out all the products that they have on sale on their website. If they do have a website, you can find the link in the description down below. So, this guy is on loan. We had a little swap loan. He borrowed my Ferrum Forge Stinger and I borrowed his Para 3 with these custom scales. And this is what we're going to talk about today. These custom scales are from a company called Fireside Company. Fireside Co. You can check it out. Fireside Company. You can just Google them. Now, one thing we gotta talk about is the shape of these scales versus the shape of a regular Para 3. I do not have a regular Para 3. I only have a Para 3 lightweight, but the overall shape of the Para 3 lightweight is the same as the regular Para 3. And the biggest difference you can see between this guy and this guy is that this is one of their slim models. So what does slim mean? Well, if you can see here, you have this nice little hump here, and this hump here is nice for ergonomics, especially if you have bigger hands where you have a little bit more gap here, where you just want to wrap around a little bit. Now, the slim models by Fireside & Co. has a slight hump. The hump has been reduced to a much more smaller amount. And the reason why they can do this is that the Para 3 naturally has a lightness on the inside there. I don't know if you guys can see that. It doesn't go all the way to the edge of this G10 of a regular Para 3. So when they took this, they managed to trim it down a little bit. And then the mold that they use is actually a little bit thinner. So just to compare with you, okay, I don't know if you guys can see that. That is the difference between the hump on a regular Para 3 and the hump on this Fireside Co. scale. So that is the big difference in terms of its ergonomics. And because of that, people with smaller hands like myself, I've only had this for 2 days and I find this extremely comfortable in hand. You don't have that little hump that kind of pushes your arm, your fingers out a little bit like they would normally do, and then you get this nice, nice comfortable grip here. Now it's kind of akin to, similar to, no, not this guy. Yeah, like this guy. It's kind of akin to this 10 gram Santa Fe. You have this nice smaller reach here that you guys can grip. It actually has very similar ergonomics to another knife that I would consider superior in terms of its ergonomics to the Para 3, which is the Native 5. So the Native 5 also has a hump right here, although because of the geometry of the rest of the handles, the hump actually feels less prominent in the Native 5 Salt, which is why I feel like this is the best knife in terms of its ergonomics. So this guy, this Para 3 with the Fireside scales, has that nice little feature. Another advantage of this scale to the regular Para 3 scales is that the material is not G10. This material is called Terotuf, T-E-R-O-T-U-F. I'm not exactly sure what it is. It does feel a lot like micarta, in my opinion. From what it looks like, it kind of looks like they took some cloth or some cloth or whatever, and then they kind of press it together with some resin, which is actually the same process as making micarta. Now, I cannot say it is the same as micarta, but I can comfortably say that it feels very similar to micarta. It has a similar kind of texture, and I really like that about this. And I really like the color as well. They call this navy blue, but it looks a lot like a pair of jeans, blue jeans that have been cut into the shape and then pressed together with some resin. So that is Terotuf. Does it have any advantage over G10? It's a bit smoother than the G10. The G10 comes out a little bit rougher, but the G10 and along with the Terotuf can soften up over time as well. Another advantage over this, the regular Para 3, which I've held before, is that the edges of the Para 3 are not as well chamfered as this guy. The chamfering on the edges here are a lot softer, so they kind of like mold into your hand a little bit better compared to the regular Para 3, which, you know, the molding, the edges here are a little bit harsher. And on the inside here is actually a little bit smoother as well. In the regular G10 Para 3, the scales on the inside here, they're a little bit sharp, okay? They are not so different from the lightweight, where the inside here is a little bit sharp, at least from what I can remember. But this guy here, quite a bit smoother than the regular Para 3, I really like. Now, what do you lose when you go to this guy? Well, you lose the reversible pocket clip. The pocket clip is only available on one side, whereas in a regular pair of 3, you have reversible left and right, and then you can have it tip up or tip down. Now, this is not really a big deal for me because this is my favorite way of carrying it. I am a right side carry with a tip up carry, and I think most people are right handers, so most people are not going to be too bothered by it on the right hand side right here. And even fewer people like tip down carry. So, but that's something you need to be aware of when you go to this guy. Another little caveat I want to talk about is that Hadith also changed the screws. These are TI screws from Flytanium, and they actually go really well. It's nice deep blue here with the these bronze colored titanium screws. Do look really nice together. Just keep in mind, if you ever get titanium screws, titanium is not actually a very hard metal compared to steel, so you can strip this out quite easily if you're using a very high HRC bit which is made of steel. So that's it. So in conclusion, I really like this. I'm okay with the Para 3. I'm not that big of a fan of the Para 3 because of the ergonomics, because of how blocky the regular G10 scales feel, and how big it feels in the hand with that little hump. But this scale fixes it, because you have a much smaller hump, which is a lot more comfortable in my smaller hands. The edges here have been chamfered a little bit more than the regular G10, so they kind of like they feel a little bit more rounded, and then they kind of mold to your hand a little bit better. And the weight is really just about the same. I measured this earlier. Now this is going to be in grams, so you're going to need to convert it a little bit later on. The regular Para 3, I think, is about 3.1, 3.2 ounces. Not that big. This guy is coming in at about 86 grams, which is, I converted it earlier, it's right over 3 ounces, 3.06 or 3.05 ounces. So the weight difference is not going to be a lot. Okay, so yeah, there you go, guys. One thing we need to be aware of is that whenever you get a set of custom scales, the tolerances might run a little bit. Now, when you read onto their website, they do give a little bit extra space, a little bit extra tolerance to make sure that, you know, they can deal with the variants of different pair of threes. So just keep in mind that when you guys get this, I've tried to tighten this, I'm still getting a bit of blade play. Now Hadith tried to tighten it, he's still getting a little bit of blade play. Bappa, which is another guy here in the community, he tried to get rid of the blade play. It couldn't really go away either. I think it's just the tolerance of the scales, you know, when they come in, since it's made aftermarket. And then when you send the scales, it's not like you can check it on that particular blade and then send it back. It's just going to cost too much money. Speaking of money, how much are these scales? Well, the TerraTurf here, it costs $85 on their website. So if you're interested, you can get this. Now, my ultimate feelings about this is that this has now become one of my 2021 goals. I like the Para 3. If you see like my videos of if I could only keep one knife, the Para 3 lightweight always comes out on top in the last two videos, okay? And that is because of the ergonomics, that is because of the hard use, because of the compression lock, because of because of a lot of things of this knife. I love the deep carry pocket clip. And the only reason I would sell this knife is to get a regular Para 3 and custom make it, but I could not find what would be the best custom skills out there to get for it, until I found this guy. So, 2021 goals is to get a regular Para 3, sell this guy, get a regular Para 3, and then exchange it with these scales, and then also get a deep carry pocket clip. Now, with the deep carry pocket clip, I do not know how much it will change the ergonomics, because the ergonomics here fit quite well. This clip right here fits right into the middle of my palm right here. So I don't know how much it will change when I put a deep carry pocket clip. Okay guys, thank you. Thanks once again to Hadith from Gear Evo. Check out all their links in the description box down below. And thanks guys, stay ready.